Hey guys, I'm back again with another review, but this time we're going indie with Radiant Black. They said if you liked Invincible or Power Rangers, then you'll love this. And let's get into the issue one, shall we? We start the first issue with a crippling debt of 38k as someone is trying to get a loan. The bank he's trying to get a loan with so he can pay off that debt is not helping as they will not give him one. He asks if they can give him a couple thousand, but they're not budging as they need him to get better income. He tries to bargain with the rep by asking for a small loan until he can get that writer's deal from his agent. The bank tells Mr. Burnett that they cannot do anything, but when his situation changes, feel free to call them back. Nathan here starts breaking down crying as his Uber customer asks if they need to get another ride, if he's not okay to drive, but he mans up and drives off with his customer. 1 week later, Nathan is back home in Lockport, moving back home temporarily with his mom and dad. They're happy that he's back home. Nathan doesn't like the fact that his dad is okay with him failing as a writer. His mom tries to cheer him up by saying you can be a writer from anywhere, even from home, just until you get back on your feet. And before you know it, you'll be getting them deals left and right. We see Nathan's friend Marshall has come to greet the great writer back home, and since he's down on his luck, asks his mother if he can take Nathan out for drinks. Marshall finds out that Nathan is 38k in the hole and asks did he buy a car and forget about it. Nathan says it's complicated, but he can get a big payday if he can get his story to his agent for a contract. Only problem? He hasn't started yet. Marshall asks if his parents can help, but figured they don't even know. Nathan couldn't ask them because his dad freaks out about beer being $12. Nathan says he's gonna die old, drunk, and alone. Marshall says, well, you're broke, so you're on your way, as a joke, but says maybe your luck will change if he gives Nathan ideas for a story. But in the meantime, he'll love it back home. After a night of drinking, the pair start to leave, with Marshall saying that they can write together like they used to, maybe even on that action idea they had in high school. Just as they're about to leave, Marshall spots a black sphere. They go towards it and see it's not some drunken hallucination. Marshall says it looks like some black hole, and Nathan decides to grab it. The energy envelops Nathan, and he's covered by some suit. Nathan says he doesn't feel any different, but Marshall tells him that he looks vastly different from before. Nathan freaks out and vomits without taking his helmet off. Some cops show up, and they're very suspicious of Nathan in costume, puking by the train tracks. Marshall says they're fine as his friend is just trying to sober up. The cops tell them they can't be on private property. The cops also see the train coming and ask them to get off the tracks, but Marshall seemingly won't move until they leave first. The train almost hits them as Nathan activates the suit's powers and everything starts levitating. The cops want to be put down, but Marshall questions will they arrest them after being put down. One officer says they won't because how would you even write a believable report with all this happening? Marshall hopes Nathan can fly, seeing him levitate things. The pair start to fly off after putting the cops down. Later, Nathan and Marshall can't believe what just happened. A black hole that gives a really cool suit and powers. Nathan is trying to take off the helmet and starts to stress out when he can't. Marshall tells him to breathe and to think about removing the helmet since that's how he made things float, or flying. The helmet disappears and Marshall says Nathan will need him to figure out what else the suit can do. Nathan gets pissed saying that he didn't ask for his help or making the situation worse. After that, Nathan calms down and comes clean about everything from the beginning, that there was no big deal with his agent, he didn't even have an agent, just some agent he bugged into looking at his story when he hadn't even done anything, or actually even started to write anything yet. Nathan feels like a screw up and ruining everything he does. He doesn't want to screw this up as well. With what the suit can do, it must be very important. Marshall tells him that he isn't a screw up and he won't let him be one either. As the comic ends, we see in Chicago that someone robs a bank in a similar suit with a red variation. My thoughts on Radiant Black, number one, it was pretty good at depicting being down in your luck when you try and chase your dreams but get nowhere. As Nathan has a debt of 38k and he's trying to get by being an Uber driver until he can get a writing deal, but breaks down because he knows the truth. I did like Marshall as an easygoing and well-meaning friend that doesn't always think about his actions when it involves others, as I want to see more of their friendship because I think Nathan views Marshall like a brother at this point. The suit's design is amazing, and having gravity powers can be really OP when utilized correctly. And I love that Nathan acts like a real person who is racked with guilt of screwing things up as well, because he knows something like this suit must be extremely important. to whoever created it. That should be it. Stay safe, guys, and I'll see you on the next one.
Hey, gamers! Don't forget to sub to the channel and follow us on Twitter.